responses, I will do them for you, or we can do it together if you want to repeat after me. But first and foremost, as far as announcements, Tuesday, I have a session meeting with the Presbyterian Church at 4:30. I also have a couple of meetings Tuesday. I also have a funeral tomorrow. Charles LeMann died this last week, and his funeral will be at 11 o'clock at the St. Ansgar Funeral Home. Today is visitation from 4 until 6 at the funeral home, so if you would like to come and pay your respects to Linda, yeah, thank you, and their family, please do so. I will be there at 3 to say a prayer with the family, and so just know that that is happening this weekend and tomorrow. Also, I will be out of the office on Friday. I have a few meetings to attend to, and so I'll be available by phone. So if you need me, please give me a call. I'll have it with me. But otherwise, the office will be closed on Friday. I think those are all the announcements, unless Dean has something.
I was just checking with the songs that we're going to sing. They are all in your hymnal.
They are in the hymnal.
And I'll let you know what the numbers are.
That would be great. All right. Well, then let us, Dean, you're up for lighting of the Advent candles. So as Jill is making copies, you get to you get to help us out on that.
Isaiah 40, 3 through 5. A voice of one calling, in the wilderness prepare the way for the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be raised up, every mountain and hill made low. The rough ground shall become level, the rugged places a plain. And the glory of the Lord will be revealed. All people will see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. Peace is the light that sheds understanding.
Peace is the promise of God.
Peace is found when God's order and justice are brought to the world.
We await the birth of the Prince of Peace.
Thank you.
to think about Christ every day. And in our lesson today, what you'll hear very shortly is John the Baptist. Do you remember the movie yesterday, Baby John? He came before Jesus, and he's a cousin. And John lived in the wilderness, and he told the people to prepare the way of the Lord. And so you're going to hear that today. And do you really think John wanted them to work on the roads to prepare for the Lord? No. What do you think he wanted them to do? To pray and prepare our hearts, right? So no matter how good people are in the world, we always still have some rough edges, don't we? We tend to judge people and we do bad things sometimes, don't we? But John wanted us just to make sure we make our way straight. And so during Christmas season, or Advent, which we're in, we need to prepare our hearts and smooth out those rough edges. And the good news is God will help us. So let's ask him to do that for us now. And maybe if I'm on top of things, we can find an Advent calendar for the church. How's that? We can do that. And then each week we can come in and open up a gift. How's that? All right, let's have a word of prayer. Holy and gracious God, we do ask that you help smooth out those rough edges we have. Help us be kinder to each other. Help us to spread our love to others around us. And just help us listen to what is happening in our world today. And help us spread peace to all. In your holy name we pray. Thanks for coming up. By the end of, next week, he'll know when I open that box that he's getting a treat. Because right now, he hears that song and he kind of runs away. But he's a smart guy. One of my friends sent me a Christmas tree with dog treats in it a few years ago, and it had bells on it. And when I rang those little bells, he was, right there. So, yeah. I need to make something like that for adults. But then everybody would know we were getting onto those treats. All right, so our scripture today comes from the Gospel of Luke. It is from chapter 3, verses 1 to 6, and it is the proclamation of John the Baptist. And you'll have to excuse my language of these towns, because I can't pronounce them all correctly. So, the reading from Luke 3. In the 15th year of the reign of Emperor Tiberius, when Pontius Pilate was governor of Judea, and Herod was ruler of Galilee, and his brother Philip was ruler of the region of Iturea and Trachonius, and Lysanias ruler of Abilene, during the high priesthood of Annas and Caiaphas, the word of God came to John, son of Zechariah, in the wilderness. And he went into all the region around the Jordan, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. As it is written in the book of the words of the prophet Isaiah, the voice of the one crying out in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord and make his path straight. Every valley shall be filled, every valley and mountain and hill shall be made low, and the crooked shall be made straight, and the rough ways made smooth, and all flesh shall see the salvation of God. This is the word of the Lord. And let us pray. Holy and gracious Spirit, we find you here today in the hustle and bustle of the Advent season, and yet we ask that you help us find that peace. Bring us into that space where we can feel you enter into our hearts and our minds and open our ears to hear the message you have for today. And Lord, I ask, may the words of my mouth and the meditations upon all of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. It's a waiting with intention. It's a waiting where we purify ourselves and prepare for holy living. It was declared back in 381 AD, the Council of Saragossa ordered the people to fast. And now fasting is no longer part of the Advent season. But let me back up for just a minute and define Advent. It is the time of daily worship, daily reflection, and daily focus. A time to stop what we are doing, catch our breath, and renew our strength. The strength which we get from the only one who can do that for us, God. As I said last week, we do get caught up in such that hustle and bustle of the holiday season that we sometimes miss that true meaning of Christmas. And maybe sometimes the older I get, the more I sound like a Scrooge during Advent because, you know, it just gets so tedious. But yet, why do we cram so much into these 24 days when we have 365 days to do it all in? I know the answer, and most of you do too. And yet we don't always like to hear the truth. And that truth is Christmas has become so commercialized. With Santa Claus, and the only way Christmas can happen at times is with Santa. And that hurts. And yet it's true, but I'm wondering what would happen if we actually put baby Jesus in replace of Santa. Would the message of Christmas change? I'm not wrong in all of this. Charles Schulz had a wonderful The Christmas Story of Charlie Brown, and it'll be coming up on TV shortly. Charlie loves to be a bah humbug during Christmas season because he doesn't understand the whole meaning. And it's hard for him to get into that season because he's fed up with his friends. And it wasn't until little Linus, dragging his little blue blanket along beside him, stands up in front of them and quotes the Christmas story. It was then that Charlie Brown understood the meaning of Christmas. He understood what God was telling them and telling him about stepping up, not just once a year. Because if we believe the Spirit lives within us every day, Christmas can be with us 365 days. And so let us think about that for a minute, where the beginning of Luke chapter 3 is much like that hustle and bustle. You heard those names of those high priests and those in the regions of such and such. And even though Luke is setting up that scene for John in the wilderness and for us to understand what's really going on, he just throws those key players in like nothing's going on. We have Tiberius and Pontius Pilate and Herod Antipas and Philip and Lysana and Anna and Caiaphas. What does that all mean? Who cares? But they're all rulers. They're important in the story of Jesus because they're subject to Rome and they're responsible for keeping peace. And yet, at some point, as we know, they're going to be upstaged by a baby. And John the Baptist also upstaged them, a wilderness prophet from Judea. Who would have guessed? He was known, and he was continually known today for his crazy actions. He wore sackcloth, ate honey, and whatever else he did in the wilderness. And yet he's shouting, "Prepare the way of the Lord." Who would want to listen to someone who lived in the desert and ate locusts? But obviously his followers did. And he had crowds around them, and they're trying to figure out, what is John trying to tell us? And all John says is, prepare the way. Meaning, we need to once again clean out the baggage in our life. Whatever is surrounding our hearts, whether it's doubt, whether it's fear, whether it's anger, in order for Jesus to come in. Because once Jesus fully takes over, he'll take our life from there. And this message is not just for us sitting here this morning, it's for everyone to hear. As life has gone on, and I've told my parents and my family and friends this, some of us have lost the meaning of what it means to be Christian. So everyone needs to hear that God is calling his people. Our tagline in the United Church of Christ is, no matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, you are welcome. And God is calling you. God calls you whether you understand what the meaning of Christmas really is or what the season is all about. He's calling us to reevaluate our life. And whether we think we know more or have more faith than the next person outside, we all need to step outside of our little box and step up our devotion to our God. That is the meaning of Christmas for us here in the church walls. But for those outside, they just need to hear it. They need to see it in action. Because if we come into church and we act one way and we go outside the church and act another way, which I know some people do, can't say that for you because I don't know you all that well, but I've witnessed it. I've witnessed people walk into a bank and demand themselves to be waited on before the next person. That is not being a Christian. Christians are supposed to be peaceful and joyful and patient and kind and humble. And I understand that it's sometimes not in our wheelhouse to always be like that because we could be in a hurry. I get it. But let's step it up. Let's bring this routine of Advent into our Christmas season and not miss the point. The prophet Isaiah, to which John quoted, says, "The voice of the one crying in the wilderness says, prepare ye the way of the Lord. Make his path straight." And what that means to me is we just need to be more serious, taking of our inventory of our own inner lives and our own way that we prepare. Making our path straight in our hearts. Because the way God is to come into our lives is a path that is clear of debris, clear of doubt, clear of resignation. It shouldn't be an uphill battle. So let's try and not get caught up in the hurried ways of what we know now. Because in time, things happen. And today, God is telling us that he's in control. And he's full of wonderful surprises. Surprises that do not need to be really opened on Christmas. Because I believe that God steps in when we least expect it. And he says sometimes we just need to shake things up. And it's God's way of telling us to be patient, to be peaceful, to be hopeful, and reminding us to trust him. So prepare your way, whatever that looks like. We have 2 more weeks left to see how God can change us and bring light into the world. Let us give thanks to him. Amen. Our hymn of response is, "Whoa, how it grows, they're moving." It's hymn number 255.
Thank you.
going in. Bill was here, one of the kids. And they sang with the Will Parts. And then we had a great movie called The Star, correct? And it was an animated movie about the birth of Christ. And if you haven't seen it, you should go take a look at it. Because even the older kids that were here thought they enjoyed it immensely. So take a look at it. It was our first annual. And I think it went off well. And I'd like to thank Green and Ashley Cooper and Jill and the rest of the leadership team that put that all together.
Yes, thank you, Dean. And if you can't find The Star, I'm willing to rent it out to you. So I have it. It's my copy. So any others to be lifted up in prayer? Then let us come to God in prayer. Holy and gracious God, we do thank you for this day. We thank you for helping us understand what it means to prepare for that peace and that hope to enter in. We ask that we're able to continue that feeling into our daily lives and show others what it means to follow you. Lord, we come to you today and we ask that you be with all who are living with an illness, who are suffering today, just maybe because, just who knows why. But Lord, we also ask that you be with the family of Charles LeBan, and be with Linda as they continue to walk through this time of death, this time of possible uncertainty. Fill their hearts with joy and love and peace as people come and surround them. Lord, we also give thanks for the healing for Ray and for Marge. We pray that they continue to find your healing spirit among them so they are able to come and be with us again. And Lord, we pray for Judy Cramey. And we pray, Lord, that you just fill her with strength as she and Ed face these days of winter coming in. Lord, we also continue to pray for our men and women of the military and their families. We pray, Lord, also for our nation's leaders, our states and local leaders. And Lord, we pray for all of our medical workers, our hospital workers, and all that work also in our assisted living and nursing home places. Lord, we just ask for continued strength and encouragement to all. And so, Lord, we also bring to you the joys in our lives. We celebrate the excitement of this season with you. We celebrate a first year of showing a movie to the kids and family and community yesterday. We give thanks for the leaders and for all who are here today. Lord, we also celebrate the birthdays and anniversaries of today and this week. And we celebrate, Lord, just celebrate with you. But most of all, Lord, we come and we celebrate your Son, Jesus Christ. And we come with the prayer that he taught his disciples to pray, praying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And now let us turn to our communion hymn, which is 287, a communion hymn for Christmas, and we're singing verses 2 and 4.
Now for
And may the Spirit of the Lord surround you as you walk through these days and wait for his return. Go in peace.